Hello, vipi watu wangu. Today I want to do a comparison between diploma in ICT NEC option, that is a NEC exam, and also diploma in ICT CASNEB option, which is again when you do a CASNEB exam. Yes, I know most of you, maybe you might be shocked kusikia kuna kuanga na CASNEB exam. Yes, CASNEB, they normally offer also an ICT course, either diploma, or maybe there is another one which is called CICT, that is Certified Information Communication Technology. That is the higher level after the diploma. When you're done with the diploma, you get to the higher level, which is certified level. For the certified level, you need to have a C+. For the diploma level, you need to have a C- to be able to qualify to do a diploma course in CASNEB. Same way, the qualification for diploma in NEC option, you still need C-. And this is a nice video for someone who has got C- and below, because I'm going to expound or to explore more on these courses so that you can get to know which is best for you. So if you have a C+, you know you qualify for a degree, and you can try to see whether you can get an admission in university for a computer science or IT or PPIT course, or even there is the computer science and mathematics, and so they normally split them in different ways. I did a video for that. You can check on my YouTube channel so that you can see the difference. And even I happen to compare the syllabuses on this area. So in this case, if you have a C+ and above, maybe you can opt to do the CICT for the CASNEB, or maybe go the degree way, of which in most cases I would prefer you can try the degree way. If you qualify for the degree, well and good. If you don't qualify, you can go direct to the CICT, and still it's not that much different. Actually, it has got more of the, you'll gain a lot of skills compared sometimes ukiangalia in some institution or in some universities. Utapata CASNEB kuna ukipata good institution yenye inaweza kutrain, you can gain a lot of skills. So let's not deviate from that topic, which is the difference between the DICT and CASNEB and different and CASNEB and DICT in NEC option. So first of all, let's compare. The qualification first is the same. That one does not have any difference. It's C-. Two, the levels that we have got, this one has got three levels. That is level one, level two, level three. Each level has got 4 units. And on the other side, this one, we don't call them levels, we call them modules. So this one has got module one, which has got around six units that are examinable, and one you can call it a project or what, it's a business plan which you just write it. Then module 2 has got 6 units, and module 3 has got 4 units. So in terms of units, you can see NEC has got so many units compared to CASNEB in some areas, not even some areas, in almost all the areas, only in module 3 where you find that they have got four, not even four, because they have in module 3 NEC we have got the project, which is the 5th one. So with CASNEB, modules are less. Let's get to the other part, which is in terms of duration. Duration on NEC area, you'll find that duration you're supposed to go for 3 years, 3 complete years. And for the CASNEB, you normally go for 1.5 years if you manage to pass all the exams. Like after 6 months, you are ready for level one. Then after other 6 months, you just go direct. You don't wait. Unangoja tu exam inatoka, unaendelea na masomo. So, kama for example, umeanza January, by May, utafanya mtihani. Hiyo mtihani ingine ya level two, unafanya by November. Then you are done by next year, May. Unakuwa umemaliza diploma yako. Unlike the NEC, which in most institutions, this is the one that is offered by so many institutions, especially technical training institutes. They normally offer these ones, and most of the private colleges have been training this course for a long time. So module one, hiyo lazima uchape mwaka moja, hakuna excuse, hakuna venye utaweza fanya 6 months. But ukienda some institution, if it's private institution, unaweza janjaruka uone kama wanaweza kukuregister. But I doubt if they will accept, because at the end of the day, hapo ndio pesa wanga inacheza. Though it is not even allowed by NEC, you're supposed to go for 1 year. After that, you go for an attachment for like 3 months, which is another term, because in most cases colleges we normally go for terms. So term one, term two, term three. So after the first module, which is 1 year, unafaa kwenda for attachment for 3 months, which is the first term of the second year, ambapo utarudi shule half by May somewhere there, if you started like January. So May you will start module 2, which you do for the 6 units, and module 2 is the toughest one. Hii ndio iko na zile units mzito. SAT, actually SAT si ngumu sana, but ukifika kwa object oriented, if you go to visual basic, database and networking is not there. We have got quantitative techniques. At least hapo kuna unit mzito mzito zitapatana nazo. And even AutoCAD and things like QuickBooks and so forth, FA, artificial intelligence, ziko hapo module 2. And still that one you'll go for 6 months. Ikiwa hivyo mzito hivyo. So you'll go for 6 months. 6 months in hiyo ni kumaanisha ni two terms. Two terms kuanzia May to November ufanya mtihani. Then after that you are done with module 2. Then you go again for an attachment. Because diploma ya NEC inakuwa na attachment mbili, which zinasaidianga sana in case kama utapata placement, unaweza pata unaweza gain skills. So after the second attachment unarudi tena for other two terms. So the first term ya mwaka wa tatu itakuwa ni attachment, the second and the third terms hizo ndo unasoma na unafanya mtihani ya final exam and you are good to go. So hizo hakuna excuse, complete 3 years unamaliza ukifanya that one. Unless now uende kwa hizo institution nimekwambia, maybe private institution, or maybe uende ujaribu kucheza kad uone kama watakubali, but I doubt they will accept that, because NEC, it goes even your coursework counts, like your class attendance, things like assignment cards and final the internal exams like end terms exams and so forth. Hizo vitu zote zinakuanga compiled, tunapeleka around 30%. 30% it means tunafaa kupelekea maxi yako. Then NEC watakupea mtihani out of 100, then they convert it up to 70, ndio waongeze hii coursework. So it goes like that. So it means hapo hakuna excuse ya ati kusema utaenda shule kusoma, like KSNEP. KSNEP unaweza choose usiende shule, ujisomewe mwenyewe, bora tu uende ufanye mtihani na upite mtihani, that's all. Ukianguka unarudia tu roho safi. NEC the same way, ukianguka utarudia, hakuna excuse kurudia. In case ukianguka units more than 3, hapo uwezi hiyo unit yote inahesabiwa, hiyo course like hiyo level yote module inahesabiwa ni kama umeanguka. So the maximum units that you can fail, they are 3. KSNEP I'm not sure, ni kitambo sana niifunze. It was back in 2015-2016 somewhere, hapo ndio nilikuwa nafunza, maybe 2015 somewhere there. So yeah, so in terms of the years, NEC ni 3 years, KSNEP ni 1.5 years, and you are done. Ukiangalia terms of units umeona NEC iko na more units, KSNEP iko na less units. And in terms of skills wise, NEC I can say skills ni mzuri, in case maybe ukienda hapo kwa field upate attachment mzuri, unaweza iva. But ukiongea mambo na class, at least inaweza kupiga chenga, kama nikikompare hizi technical training institutes na hizi most of the colleges, you might find that a class, if it's more, it has more than that 30 student, even 20 student, you class iko na watu wengi, because when it comes to kitu kama packages, unaweza pata maybe computers mna share. In most institutions they don't have more than 30 machines, unless your computer lab ni kubwa. sana zaidi, but I guess I doubt so. Mtaenda kushare machines and it will be quite challenging, assuming kama umetoka kwa ushago hujaishika computer, hujai even you don't know how to put a computer machine. Unaweza toka hapa kama hujaishika mouse na hujui mtihani ya NEC, but skill wise if you are keen enough, at least na unajikaza, maybe you have your own laptop, vitu kama hizo unajisukuma, you go to YouTube, look for resources and so forth. Skill wise NEC it is very nice, itakupea a lot of content, a lot of skills and so forth. Inakupenga kale ka platform ka kugrow, so ukijipush kiasi unaweza kuwa uko fit, because ukiangalia units zake utapata ukikompare na za degree hata hazijaachana sana, utapata it's more of the degree coursework, it's all covered there. So ukikuwa unakuja kama units za computer maths, quantitative methods, unaopata like more of the mathematics yenye inakuwa kwa degree, ni kama hizo chapters ziko compressed hapo ndani. Programming karibu yote, object oriented dance kwa object oriented, hakuna kastori ingine. Only that which is not here, it's mobile development, but you go to degree utapata kuna kuanga na mambo ya labs and so forth, which is not in NEC. That's why sometimes I normally say it's good they change the syllabus. Kwa CASTEB hapa hakuna kitu kama hiyo, but ka course kenyewe kako na a lot of practicals, like ukiongea stuff ya computer application, hiyo packages hapo mse wa DICT ya CASNEP, when it comes to packages unataka mse ya operate computer na hafanya stuff mob na just MS Office, huyu mtu anakuanga more qualified, ni mse anaweza maliza hivi immediately aende aajiriwe mahali kama ni kufunza computer application na ako fit. Unlike NEC unaweza pata unless umejikansa kivyako, kiimagine kama hizi TTI unaweza pata its UI. I can doubt many people they can have those skills that are good, especially when it comes to what utapata kuna vitu kama kuweka table of content, page number, like kuweka different page numbers, kuna vitu minor unapataka ujui. Ukienda kwa Excel formulas unapata kuna wazini wapiganga chenga completely, actually after exam ndio unapatanga mtu ni hivyo amefanya mtihani, akitoka hapa nje akaenda mahali apewe interview, just an Excel like kwa interview naweza pata ni wengi wanaweza anguka. So ukikompare mse wa CASNEP, they are well qualified when it comes to that part, ya Word, Excel, Access, PowerPoint, even publisher, they are good in that area. Then we have got you can see computer maths, say communication skills and entrepreneur, hizi ni kama combined units. Ukiangalia hapa in terms of this kuna computer networks. Kwa NEC, hii computer networks iko module 3. Internet skills NEC hakuna, of which internet skills ni kitu inafaa kuongezewa, hata kama itaongezewa kama topic kwa computer networks. It's something which is very essential, at least kujua vitu kama security, nini, how to Google search. Kuna wasee tu at least wamemaliza, na ukimwambia tu wako copy-paste project kwa internet, haedi itauzie mtu hawezi. But these are some of the basic skills that we need, at least zinahitajika pale nje. So this course has got those basics. Ukiangalia computer maintenance, NEC haina hiyo part ya ati ujifunze kuinstall and all that. Though operating system mwalimu anafaa kukutake through this. But yeah, ukiangalia hapa kuna computer support and maintenance, wanafanya kazi assembling, disassembling of machine. You need to know each and every component pale, ku replace kama ni hard disk, all that kind of stuff. Unapata hii lazima uende deep. Programming concept, it's more like a structure programming, lakini iko kidogo less compared to NEC. NEC iko more deeper, because hapa wafanyangi any language, it's just the concept itself. But NEC unaona kuna C language na kuna Pascal, where I can say sometimes Pascal is not important. Now, when it comes to web development, this one is far much deeper compared to the NEC. NEC it's more shallow. Actually NEC, so long as unajua HTML, you are good to go. But CASNEP, actually my friends, hii pepa unaweza anguka. Nimeangalia content yake, it's far much deeper. FA, you just need the skills of doing business and so forth and accounting. We have got information systems, which is more of a kind of MIS and a little bit something like that. Then computer application 2, which is not like the one in NEC. This is just Access, Excel and publisher. So there is a lot of content which is missing, which is in the NEC area. when you check the content skill wise, these are the skills that are needed out there. If you go there and you want to be just an IT specialist, administrator, kufanya networking kwa kampuni, just kusaidia watu maybe document za Excel, Word, upate tu skills kiasi tu publishing software like Wunder Banners and so forth. Unaweza advance tu skills uingie kwa graphic design pia, networking wa kofiti, skills hizi kama za internet skills, computer maintenance, installation and so forth. And when it comes to web development too, say anaweza kuwa full web developer. Good potential, like for example, when we talk of this is a paper for CastNet. You can see there is XML, they are talking of UX design. And neck would always come say a kibonga story come by so it's more of HTML. And kiangalia kuna scripting jacket like JavaScript or what I can learn, how to use Flash, it come by so neck and very few things. Responsive design, neck another patada, another part of J for them to come by so. And still they will pass the exam. Ukiangalia kuna mambo na working with APIs, forms, unaona iko more advanced. I checked even MySQL database, how to connect. So you need to learn how to host your website and so forth. So with CastNet kuna ka story na shortcut hapa kwa web utaiva. Ukitaka tu utaiva, utoke hapa tu nje uanze kuunda ma website and so forth. Compared to NEC, wacha angalia NEC. NEC hapa unaona tu sijui wanasema nini. Ukiangalia hapa ni HTML. This is a paper for NEC. So the only question utapata maybe ka JavaScript kamoja tu. So long as you maybe tu HTML, hii ya NEC huwezi anguka. Check. So that's why I normally say haiwezi kusaidia in most cases. Unahitaji kujipush to that next level. So at least kwa NEC iko na content, iko fiti. Na at least ukienda hapo upate mwalimu wako competent. Maybe anataka kuwa push beyond the wacha kupita mtihani, because in most cases we normally focus na kupita mtihani. But kama unaweza pata mwalimu ambaye anataka ku push beyond that, like my student, I used to show them how to connect, how to use PHP, vitu kama hizo, how to connect with the database. At least yule msee kutumia Dreamweaver, vitu kama hizo, at least ajipange. Inaweza hata kitokea hapa nje anaweza fanya 1, 2, 3. Even sometimes web kutumia WordPress ndipo anaonyesha vitu kama hizo, at least to advance their skills, because in this idea, see, it's not about just giving them the to pass the exam, at least at your PTMTN. Not only that, they need to do more than that. This is a paper for CastNet, the computer application. You can see this is publisher. You're gonna make success in MS Excel questions, theory practical questions. So these are questions that it could be a headache. No, not about 3 hours complete. Unlike NEC, ukizangalia kama ni practical utapata ni 2 hours, not even 2 hours, sometimes it goes for like 1 hour, something like that, which if you compare for someone, it's all about ni kama wanatakanga to type the document. Once you type, you get like, because you can see when it comes to easy maswali za practical, ukitengeneza tu kitu venye ilikuwa imetengenezwa, like ukiandika hata kama uja format sana, you get almost half of the marks. And you can imagine kama NEC umepewa tu swali ya Word na Excel, just kutype your data already ushapata around 30 marks. If we say 15, maybe the question, if it consists of 30 marks, 30, 60, something like that. So you'll have the half of the marks. So you need more advanced skills when it comes to this. So in terms of the skills wise, I can say NEC, if you are more focused and you go through attachment, and attachment in your mind, at least in the skills, because I remember when I went for attachments, that's when I learned about CorelDRAW, Photoshop and all that. And if it was inside younger sana in life, sometimes I can go through that. Even though more on still go format machine literally younger uko, unapatanga hata ukifunzwa in most cases, wasi ya wakufunzangi hizo stuff za what we refer to as the name, the formatting computers and so forth. It's all about work with the content. That's why sometimes we prefer, like ukienda kwa private institutions, mwalimu lazima akuwe hapo, because akiko miss class maybe kamshahara katakato, lakini mwalimu wa hizi TTI, and my friend, those guys, they don't take nini awashtukangi juu at the end of the day mtihani, serikali lazima iweke mshahara kwa account. So this is the programming part of it, run a commercial. So I can say, these are the, for the CASNEP area, these are the skills that are needed out there in the market. At least kako brief, short, not too much content, but what is relevant. But on the neck, it has got the required content in the industry, but maybe in terms of how it is covered, how to achieve it, the formula might have so many issues. There is more of theory content, which is more irrelevant. I can say something like that, but it's a nice one. It's a nice one. It's a good thing. In case ukiangalia ni vile maana nilikuwa nakwambia, almost 70-80% of the content is like similar to the content that is covered by the degree guys. And if you can nurture yourself very well, you can find that it's very easy to fit in an area that even a degree student can fit, and you'll be good to go. That's why sometimes I normally say a diploma and a degree student, they don't have any difference. Because now when you go to most of the universities, they normally cover things theoretically. Still, yeah, a little bit, you can say, another format. So, ni kama mko on the same level in most cases. It's all about venye utajituma, venye utajikaza kivyako kwa hii field. I always tell people, we are all driven by the passion. So, I think I've talked about the years, the content in terms of skills, and I want to finalize with the cost. The cost, yeah, the mode of learning here, CASNEP, nilisema you can go, unaweza jisomea wewe mwenyewe, unatafuta msee ameiva, anakufunza, unaweza ongea tu kama leo tunaongea na kufunza, alafu wewe unaenda unafanya mtihani. So it means cost yangu inaweza kuwa cheap, because it means I just need to provide you with notes, then tukao tunapitia some few past papers, and you'll be good to go, utaenda upite mtihani, and naweza focus na zile vitu zinaweza kusaidia. So in terms of cost, hapo unaweza pata umecut cost, but in because most of the easy institution kama GAVA, ama even most of the private institution, they rarely offer this ICT course. You know, CASNEP is well known in the accounting area. So only in Nairobi, ndipo ndio unaweza pata wasee wanafunzanga ICT, DICT ya CASNEP. And they normally charge like 13,000, something like that. So it's cheaper compared now to NEC, which is like, I think TTI, they normally charge either 15K when I choose something like that. And you compare like utakula, kunanga food provided, there's things like rent and all that. Yeah, sometimes I can say the diploma one, it's more expensive compared to this one. Now, ukiangalia duration yaka, unasoma within 1.5. So ile pesa unalipa ya NEC ya mwaka wa kwanza is like almost the full amount ya kulipa DICT ya CASNEP. So mwaka moja ya NEC ni kama similar to the mwaka moja, the whole cost of the nini. So the cost, you see that the CASNEP is quite cheap. So CASNEP inakuwa mzuri for the guys who are working, or maybe naweza kuwa maybe mzazi ana pesa ya kupeleka shule, but you have that passion ya kutaka kujifunza ama kujisomea kitu kama hizo. This is how you can move yourself in this field of IT. At least CASNEP is the best way to go, because hapo si lazima uende kwa shule kama NEC, lazima ukuwe shule because of the coursework na pia because of all those other requirements. Unless sasa ujanja unaweza tumia ni ile, you can go maybe wanda uwekeje either college, wana kama wanaweza kuchukua, ulipe tu exam na ulipe center fee ufanye. So yeah, in case maybe you might need to do a NEC course, na maybe always afford ile kulipa, but you can learn on your own, because like for example, I normally give content free of charge for NEC content. So you can take the content ujisome. Ukitaka ni kupitisha matitution kiasi, you talk to me at least to una toboka kitu kidogo, and you're good to go, uende ukalia mtihani. And in case maybe kama una place unaweza register exam, maybe tunaweza communicate, tuone kama tunaweza jiri place plan ini kwa device, zile place unaweza check depending. Unaweza pata maybe unataka mahali ambapo unajuana na mtu, na connect, unaenda una register exam, unafanya, and you're good to go. So hiyo ndio ile ujanja tunatumianga sometimes, at least unasoma, unapata at the end of the day umeshasoma na cost ilikuwa chini kidogo, something like that. So that is it, and I hope now you can get to know the difference. So if you want to go the CASNEP way, still it's relevant. It's just for the relevant skills. It can push you, I can say, more of the computer packages. They are good in that. So you can advance your computer application skills when they pack up a graphic design with that knowledge. When it comes to computer repair and maintenance, that is also another skill that you can gain very well. When it comes to web development, it's another area that you can grow on the CASNEP area. Web development, you can advance your skills, but I cannot guarantee you on any other area. So with that one, you can imagine sasa hapa unaweza anza ka cyber na ukue sasa sawa, you can serve people very well. And yeah, even ukianza uanze ku include au kutengeneza ma website, you can advance very well. With NEC, unless pale attachment gain skills very well, when you naijua, you'll find that unaweza toka hapa nje na kupata kuna kitu unaweza. But as I always tell you, it's all about passion. Passion do it up. So for the guys who have got less than C minus, because in this session I talked about the C minus guys, the D plane are the ones who qualify for the certificate here NEC. I remember CASNEP walikuwa wanataka ku introduce ka level kingine walikuwa chini ya hiyo, but I don't know whether what happened. Lakini walikuwa wanataka ianze na D plus something like that, but I don't know what happened. I don't know kama wali introduce yet to know. I research and check, but for the NEC I know with the D plane you can start a certificate, and for the certificate you can be good in repair maintenance, like the computer support and maintenance. Unaweza hizo hizo packages, but the rest hakuna story kama programming and all that, you get any mongo. So that is it. So once you do this one, you need to advance your skills by doing some of the short courses. Like for example, kama unaona graphic design utuwezi kuifanya wewe mwenyewe ujifunze, the best you can go for that short course, kufanya graphic design, kufanya Corel Draw na Photoshop, or Corel Draw peke yake, it is enough. And advance vitu kama QuickBooks uive vizuri, hizo accounting softwares, you'll be good to go. At least ukitoka hapa nje utakosanga kazi za kufanya, hata kama utaathiriwa na NGO juu wanatumianga hizo SPSS, you'll get to know. Kienda kwa most of the companies they use QuickBooks, utakosa kitu ya kufanya. Computer packages, that is MS Office, they are used like everywhere. So you'll find that you have got some skills that you can use. If you can advance your skill on web development, you can be good. On the other side of software development, especially with C++, ukitaka with NEC, you can move yourself forward. At least unaendelea kugrow. And even up to data science and so forth, I can say it's the same concept that I normally use. The QM, that is quantitative techniques, those are the ones that you normally need to advance, at least to answer plan. Now here with the NEC concept, now you can learn new programming language unlike the CASNEP. So actually that is the difference, and you can choose which one is best for you. So it will depend on the amount of money, the mode of learning that you want. These are some of the key factors that you need to check. If you don't have enough money and you just want to learn to have a valid certificate, the CASNEP is the best option. That one has got no any issues. But if you want like more content that can give you a good platform, because you never made for a deep degree, NEC option can be a nice thing for you, but you need to do an extra job so that you can learn something new. So that is it. And I would like to appreciate for the guys when you at least in the subscribe. At least I normally see each and every day, at least kuna by a video or tattoo. And tunaendelea ku grow, at least now, like more almost 4 months, something like that. 4 or 5 months, something like that. Tulianza kitu kama November. That's when I started doing serious videos on this channel. And each and every time, at least now, to keep grow, to end up in it and all that. So continue supporting this channel. If you know a guy who might need this kind of content, especially about this course, at least mweleze. If still unataka kusoma, you can communicate, maybe to owner, maybe you can get a fancy badge, you need the resources. resources. The resources unapata kwa site yangu free of charge. That is Codestar. You just need to create an account here. But once you create an account, you enroll to its courses, ICT, DLCT, and you'll be able to get them. I will approve them. It's free. We don't pay anything. Unapata notes, content, all that one, free of charge. Utasumbuka. And also there is a blog site inakuwaka nayo, inakuwaka ni Recobanks. Let me just ICT notes. It's a blog site I created long time ago. And yeah, this one, when you click it, you'll be able to see some notes that you can use, that you can download free of charge. Even past papers, and not even past papers, also you'll get the marking schemes. I normally have those kind of stuff also for NEC. And sometimes now, ukianga mtu maybe alienda akamark mtihani, they happen to get those marking schemes. And you'll be good to go. At least unapata, unaweza kujua hizo courses, sio kupita tu mtihani, unajua strategy ya kupita mtihani, and now you get your own time yenye unaweza grow in this field. So continue supporting this channel, like the video, share the video, and subscribe in case you've not subscribed. I know majority of you ni wale amja subscribe. I normally see like nikiangalia the analytics of the YouTube, I normally see like 30% have subscribed. 80% of the people who normally watch these videos have not subscribed. I'm yet to know why. At least if there is something that I'm doing different, you might need to do it differently. Share with me hapo kwa description, not description, but comment, at least niweze kujua what is it. So I'd appreciate if you subscribe so that we can grow. At least if you have your number 1,000 subscribers, at least channel isimamie kivyake. And I will appreciate, I promise I will be doing a very nice content that will help us grow together. So thank you guys, and